It's important to find Christmas tree pests before they get out of control and damage trees. But they're so small. How do you find something that's no bigger than the tip of a pin in all of this? Scouting Christmas tree pests starts with a good hand lens to see pests more clearly. Hand lenses come in many powers of magnification, as shown here. The most commonly used is a 7X. That is, it magnifies 7 times. Some people also use more powerful magnification like a 10 to 20x, but the field of view is considerably smaller, making it harder to use. A good hand lens can cost $30 or more, but the advantage is the entire field of view is in focus. Low quality hand lenses distort the image. What you see through the lens is not in focus. Cell phones can also take magnified shots of pests. You can even purchase a lens attachment for taking enhanced photos easier. This can help when diagnosing problems, as the photos can be quickly and easily shared with others. Once you pick out a hand lens, you need to practice how to use it. To start out, stand with the sun coming over your shoulder. You might want to practice looking at your fingerprint to get accustomed to focusing the lens. Different people focus in different ways, but essentially you are moving the lens between your finger and eye until it comes into focus. Once you can see through the lens in focus, you're ready to start looking for pests. But where do you start when there are so many trees? It depends on the pest you're most interested in, but a good rule of thumb is to look at about 10 trees per block, randomly scattered over the entire area. Why? Because some pests like mites and scales may be in one part of the field versus another. If you stayed in just one area or right by the road, you won't find a developing problem. Here are two people scouting a block of trees to show how the entire block is assessed. They are moving through different sides of the field as they walk through the block. While scouting, take into account how the field lays. Ridge tops tend to have more spider mites and be the first place that woolly adelgid shows up. Rust mites show up initially in protected areas with little wind. As you get to know a field and where pests are typically found, it takes less time to do a good job of scouting because you know where to go first. As you're walking, look for trees with poor color or other symptoms of pest damage. Don't forget to sample these trees also. Look for shoots of the newest growth. Smaller interior shoots tend to be the first place where twig aphids and mites show up. Remove the shoot and look at the foliage with your hand lens, both front and back. Record how many trees you look at and how many have pests. For more specific pest scouting, please reference our other videos. Tree beats add to your scouting information. Put a plate or a laminated sheet into the canopy and vigorously beat the foliage. Depending on the size of trees, you can beat over several branches on the same tree before looking to see what falls out. Use your hand lens to take a closer look at what's on your plate. In the spring, you can find bad bugs including twig aphids, scales, and spider mites. You may also find good bugs. These predators eat the bad bugs. It's important to recognize predators, as their presence will help determine treatment options. When you find a new pest, or if you need to get someone else to look at a problem, flag the tree so that you can find it again. You can even mark the GPS location with your cell phone. As mentioned before, if you see trees that have poor color or growth, take a closer look. If you're not sure what is causing a problem, take a sample to show the grower or county extension agent for positive identification. Having multiple scouts speeds up the process. Some can look at shoots, and others can take beats. Regardless, keep track of all the trees you've looked at and what you find. The need to treat with a pesticide is based on the percentage of trees with a pest present. It's important to write down what you're seeing so that you'll remember the next time you scout, or even next year when you're looking for those same pests again. Learning how to use a hand lens and walk a field to find pests is the basis for an integrated pest management program. The more you scout, the more confident you'll become. Through scouting, you can catch a developing pest problem before it causes damage, and assess how well pesticide applications have worked. You may also find that pesticide applications aren't necessary, since predators are present and effectively controlling pests. The NC State University Christmas Tree Portal has more information about each pest, treatment thresholds, and control options. Look there for other scouting videos and sample scouting sheets to record information.